Charlie and Simon, and how exciting that is, especially in today's time, for somebody to be married for 50 years is quite a blessing and quite a testament. So if you would, I'm going to ask you all to please stand. Well, Charlie and Sonny, 50 years ago, you guys did this and walked down, and everybody looked a little bit different back then. A little bit different. But again, we're here, and it is such an awesome time to celebrate. I know it was right at 30 years ago when I met you guys for the very first time. And in that time, who knew that one afternoon that I met you guys for the first time that 5 years later I'd become a part of your family, and now almost 25 years later to be here and stand here. And we've all we shared some times. We've had some real joyous times. We've walked through times that are always tough, but we've gone through that together. And that's the great thing about family. You guys have quite a legacy that not only are you leaving behind you, but you are continuing to create. And that's a great thing about a milestone like this, for us to be able to come in and celebrate with you for 50 years, and to celebrate 50 years of marriage. And so what we'd like to do is for you guys to renew your vows if you think you're up to it. Okay, all right. In 1 Corinthians chapter 13, the Apostle Paul is writing to a group of people, and he is trying to explain to them some attributes of how they're supposed to live together in harmony, how they're supposed to come together in unity. And he was talking about a community of people, but how appropriate, how appropriate the words that he wrote in chapter 13 of that chapter, and how it pertains to a family, and how it pertains to a husband and a wife, especially a husband and wife. A lot of times you'll hear this for when folks, when they're young and they're getting married, but for you guys to be looking at 50 years of this and to know that these words ring true as any time, it rings true in this on 50 years. This is what Paul said. He said, love is patient and kind. Love does not envy or boast. It's not arrogant or rude. It does not insist on its own way. It's not irritable or resentful, and it does not rejoice at wrongdoings, but rejoices with the truth. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. And when I think of the way that you guys have modeled for us, for some of the people in this room, you've been modeling it for 50 years. For me, you've been modeling it for 30 years. And I've seen you guys play these words out in the way that you respond to one another. It's not always easy. It's not always easy to do all those things that it says that love is. But I've watched you consistently keep coming back to that kind of a relationship, to keep coming back to set that forth for anyone who knows you and for all of your family. That's an amazing thing. Can we pray together? God, I thank you for Charlie and Simon. I thank you for the love that they've shown for one another. I thank you that today they can say that they love deeper and in different ways than they did 50 years ago. 50 years ago, they came with this excitement and this trying to figure out what tomorrow may hold. God, I pray that they come in the same way that they're here, with excitement, and can't wait to see what tomorrow may hold for them. So hold them close.
Sorry,
bind them together. In your name we pray. Amen. So Charlie, do you promise to continue to love Simon, to cherish her heart, to protect her, and keep her close to you? And do you promise to continue to pursue her and delight in her for as long as you shall live?
I do.
Signing? Do you promise to continue to love Charlie and to cherish his heart and to respect him and to keep him close to you? And do you promise to continue to pursue him and to delight in him for as long as you shall live? Charlie, I want you to turn and y'all face one another. And Charlie, I'm asking that you repeat after me. Signing, you have been.
Signing, you have been.
And continue to be.
And continue to be.
The absolute love of my life.
The absolute love of my life.
You captured my heart.
Captured my heart.
50 years ago.
50 years ago.
And you still have my heart today.
You still have my heart.
It was my utmost honor.
It was my utmost honor.
To pledge myself to you.
To pledge myself to you.
On our wedding day.
On our wedding day.
And I am equally as honored today.
Equally as honored today.
To commit myself to you.
To commit myself to you.
Signing, would you repeat after me? Charlie, you have been.
Charlie, you have been.
And continue to be.
And continue to be.
The absolute love of my life.
The absolute love of my life.
You won my heart.
Won my heart.
50 years ago.
50 years ago.
And you have my heart still today.
And you have my heart still today.
It was my absolute joy.
It was my absolute joy.
To commit myself to you.
You.
On the day that we were married.
On the day that we were married.
And I am filled with equal joy today.
And I am filled with equal joy today.
As I recommit myself to you.
As I recommit myself to you.
And now, as a minister of the gospel of Jesus Christ, it is my honor and privilege on this occasion, on the renewing of your vows, to proclaim a continuance of your love and devotion to one another in marriage. Charlie, you may once again kiss your bride. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my privilege on this, their 50th wedding anniversary, to present to you Mr. and Mrs. Charlie and Sidney Harrison. Moment, they're going to have a time where they're going to cut a wedding cake, an anniversary cake, and we're going to have some food. We're going to have a great time. On behalf of Charlie and Sidney, thank you for being here. We want to definitely party with you this afternoon, and so please make your way back there. Oh, are you playing a song all the way out?
I'm going to.
We've got a couple of people that are going to say some things and they're going to take some pictures. So kind of make your way back there if you can. Just a moment. And so without further ado. Smile big, Charlie.
Oh, Lord. Maybe a little stuff down to throw out.
Yeah, then go ahead and do that now. Yeah, I'm saying let's go ahead and do that now. That wasn't a question, I'm sorry. That was a statement.
Smile big.
All
right, one, two, three.
Yours, toasted.
Can I have your bouquet, please, ma'am? I'm going to set it right here to be waiting for you. And you guys are now going to go ahead and take this. And so, Charlie, you take it to your hand.
Wait, when you get everybody in here?
Sonny, you're going to put your hand on top of his. Just bring it in about right there. Just kind of into the side of it. How's that? There
padres. Yeah. If you plan on hating each other. You're good, yeah.
You guys good? Okay. Okay, folks, if you'll gather around just one second.
Gather around.
We can have your attention back here, everyone, please.